by the European Azerbaijan Society, which is called Azerbaijan Teacher Development Center. I believe that many of you, if not many of you, some of you participated in November conference that was hosted in this very campus of European Azerbaijan School, and you enjoyed the conference. So although it has been established just for 2 years, its achievements are big enough because it is pretty famous in Baku, and now with a special project it is getting more popularity beyond Baku in different regions of Azerbaijan. Today the director of the Azerbaijan Teacher Development Center, Mr. Graeme, Pollock, is has joined our opening session. We are grateful to him for his time, and so I would like Mr. Pollock also to say a few words to us, please.
Education, as has been said this morning, is very critical. It's critical for society's future. There are four key reasons. Firstly, education represents personal empowerment. It enables young people to take control of their lives. Secondly, education represents the transmission of culture, passing on of the great traditions, the thoughts, the things that are said and done in one's history from one generation to the next. Education is important for the preparation of citizenship, preparing young people to take an active role in society and to be able to make a difference to the world that they live in. Of course, education is important in the preparation for work, ensuring that our young people are able to find fulfilling and rewarding work. All of these four things are vital and critical, but there is one I want to think about today and focus on. Sadly, however, we're sometimes lost for how to do that. Technology is one of the critical things that we talk about. How many of you here could go for a day without this? But you know, this only went on sale less than a decade ago, 29th of June 2007, less than 10 years ago. And look how it has changed and impacted our lives. This is not just our phone. This is our calculator, our computer, our research tool, our library of books and our Kindle app that sits on it. It's our weather check, it's our recreation, it's our games that we play, it's our dictionary, it's our thesaurus, it's our post office where we send our mail from, it's our camera, and you've been using them as your cameras this morning. Technology is having a significant impact on the world of work. So I want you to ask yourselves, what are the children who are currently enrolled in kindergarten going to be employed in when they are in their 50s, when they are our age? And talking to a friend of mine recently, he grew up in the Midwest of an American town, he told me that the bottle factory was the major employer in that town. A small town, it employed 3,000 people. It's still there. It's still operating. It's doubled its production and trebled the manufacturing in its country. The idea is neatly encapsulated in this sort of joke about an automotive building construction company. The story goes like this. Today, you only need a man and a dog to run an automotive factory. The man is there to feed the dog. The dog is there to make sure that the man doesn't touch anything because the robots have got it under control. Technology is having a huge impact. So this brings us back to this conference. The real significance, the need for us as educators and educationalists is to keep up with and keep ahead of the changes that we and the students that we interact with on a day-to-day basis face in the years ahead. We therefore have to take personal responsibility for our ongoing professional learning and development. We have to be at the cutting edge of change, of exploring how we bring elements of higher order thinking, critical analysis, creativity and collaboration into our engaging of student learning, of the empowering of students so that they know it's not that they gather facts, it's that they know how to use the information. So I want to congratulate you all on being here, of giving up your weekend, your personal time to attend the conference, because you doing that are signalling that you are lead learners, that you are seeking to help the young people of this nation to be better prepared for and have a greater understanding of the skills and mindsets that they will need as they move into this dynamic world of change. Thank you for your commitment to this conference. I wish you and the conference a very engaging and successful today.
The secondary campus, and its primary campus is near the metro station, you might know. So when we decided to host this conference in this school, the school management immediately got back to us with attention and so with care, and they ran us through all the details to make this conference be a success from the very beginning. Through the door entering this campus, you saw how everything was smooth, and everybody, although it is Saturday, a non-working day for school staff, but many school staff are here to make you feel at home at this in their home. It is their house, actually. So I'm very grateful, first of all, to the European Azerbaijan Society, which gives a great role to the development of education in Azerbaijan. And because of that, the European Azerbaijan Society has founded Azerbaijan Teacher Development Center and European Azerbaijan School, which was established in 2011, but within a short time it has become one of the leading private schools in Azerbaijan. So we are very grateful to the European Azerbaijan Society for accepting our request to open the door of this fantastic school to us, and we are also very grateful to the management of the school for making this conference so helping, supporting this conference, and I believe that thanks to this support, we will be able to write another success story in the history of AzETA. I would like to invite here Mr. Gary Crippin to welcome you to his house, please. Thank you very much, Mr. Crippin.